In this video, I am going to discuss with you the concept of prime number. To understand the concept of prime number, I will expect you to go for the reading of the next two or three videos, right? So that you can understand the concept. Reason being, in this video, I am going to discuss you to check whether a number is prime or not, right? For that, let's say n is a number, and what I want to check it whether it is prime or not. What the way is? I hope everybody of you knew mathematically what a prime number is. If I go for its definition, the prime numbers are the number that are divisible by only two number. One is 1 or itself. So this number, if I want it to be prime, if I want to say it is prime, it must be divisible by only these two digits, only these two numbers, nothing in between. So how I can check it? There is no way. Okay, if I say, can we reverse it? Let's check it. Is this number not a prime? How we can check it? Can we start it? Can we divide it by 2? In case it is divisible by 2, is it a prime? No, it is not a prime. Reason being, it is divisible by 2. And any number that is divisible by any number which is not the number itself or 1 is not a prime number. So, in case if I divide it by 2, how I can divide it? For the division, I have two operator, one is slash, another is percentage. This gives quotient and this gives remainder. To check whether this number is divisible by 2 or not, I will go for the remainder. Right? If the remainder is 0, then this number is divisible by 2. If the remainder is 1, then the number is not divisible by 2. So how I can check it? This is the simple. So if I go for if we know n percentage 2, give me either 0 or 1. Right? Again it is a number. So can I compare it by 0? If it is true, then can I say not a prime, right? And if it is not, of course, in the else, what I will say, a prime. But can I write it is a prime just by dividing it by 2? There are some number which are not divisible by 3, but still they are prime, right? Or they can be called in the category of not a prime. For example, 5, not divisible by 2, but it is a prime. Reason being, it is not divisible by any number between 1 to 5, that is 2, 3 and 4. Right? And if I go for the 9, not divisible by 2, but it is not a prime. Reason being, it is divisible by 3. Right? So, if I have to go for that, if I have to go for its checking, whether it is a prime or not. So this is the base, right? How I am saying this is a base? I will say divide by 2, divide by 3, divide by 4, divide by 5. In case this number is divisible by any number between 1 and this, then it is not a prime number. Otherwise, it is a prime number. So what I can go for? I will go for n is a number, right? If n percentage 2 equal to 0, prime. Else, not a prime. And what else? I want this 2 to be a variable. Of course, I will go for this as a variable I, which take the value of 2, 3, 4 and so on, not 1 and not that number. Anything between these two is okay. And if I want to repeat this, so I will go for a loop. Of course, I want to start with a for loop and all this inside the body. So I will go for 4 I equal to 2, I is less than n, I plus plus. I hope everybody is understanding this, but what the problem with this is, for some number, it will, sometime it will say it is a prime and sometime it will say not a prime. For example, if I say the value of n is 9, right? And if I say, let's start with this, the value of I is 2, initialized to 2, 2 is less than 9, right? True. So it will go into the if n is 9, 9% is 2, equal to 0, no, it will say not a prime. Oh my god, I have gone for opposite. If any number is divisible, then it is not a prime, and if it is not divisible, it is a prime number. Okay, no problem. 9% is 2, equal to 0, so it will say it is a prime number. Then it will go up, and then I's value will become 3. 9% is 3 will become 0, equal to 0, so it will give not a prime. For the same data, it is giving me a prime as well as a not a prime. So what I can say, can I think of some problem in this? Of course, there is some problem, right? So I cannot say if a number is prime, the same number can be a not prime, and if a not a prime number, then it is a prime as well, right? Let's think it another way, right? If I says any number is divisible by any number, that can be cleared here, not a prime. Once it is not a prime, no need to repeat it. So can I go for its else part? Let's remove it. And what I go for, instead of continuing it, I will go for a break. And if I go for a break, so what will be the case? In case any number is divisible, then it will say it's not a prime and it will come out. So this is giving me the concept of not a prime, right? For 2, of course, the value of n as 9 and for I's value as 2, it will not work, right? If it will give the n percent is I, 9 percent is 2 will give us 1 equal to 0, nothing is there, so it will not be executed, it will go upstairs, and into that the value of I is incremented to 3, 9 percent is 3 give me 0, 0 equal to 0, so it will give me not a prime and it will come out. So what I can say, this concept is to check the number whether it is not a prime. What else I can do? I can go for its use. If any number is divisible by any number that is less than that, then that value of I will not reach to n. So, not a prime. If that value reaches to n, then it's a prime. I hope this is clear. So this is the backbone, this is the heart and soul, right? So what we have done for this, we have gone reverse. We have not gone for a prime number. We have gone for not a prime. And the side effect of that is giving me whether this is a prime number, right? Let's try to work it out with the help of the program. And for the program, I have created a project by the name prime number using the Eclipse itself, and into that let me create a class And can I assume everybody know how to create a class? Class, and the name of the class can be any. And I have given the name as this, having public static void main. And just finish. Right? What to do next? Write the concept to take a value. For that, declare a variable. Then I can go for its input or the value of it to be taken from the user. So for that, I have made the use of scanner class. It is giving me the error, right? And in case this is giving me the error, so I have to resolve this, and for that click on this. But it says the very first point it gives, import scanner class. Of course I want to import, and using that I have gone for that. And then system.println, please enter a number, right? And then I will go for I equal to s dot next int, right? Or let me declare it as n, of course using the concept that I have already covered, right? Then if I says I have to go for the this concept, right? If n percentage I equal to 0, not a prime, break, I will go for this. I will simply write if n percentage I equal to 0, then system dot out dot println. I'm just giving it not a prime, right? If n percent is I, okay. Now it is giving us the error. What the value of I is that need to be initialized, and for that what we have done, instead of writing it here itself, I have gone for I equal to 2, I is less than n, I plus plus, and followed by, right? And here I have written break. So can I say I have clear you this? Next is this, if I equal to n, if I equal to equal to n, then number is prime. Let's see whether this work or not. I have saved it and then I have gone for its execution. And once I execute it, it is executed successfully and it is asking for please enter a number. And for that, let me go for 23 and then it is giving me the result as number is prime, right? Let's execute it again. And for its execution, I will go for this again. Please enter a number. And for entering a number, I have gone for 45, right? And enter it. It's not a prime, right? Now let's cover some of the combination that we have covered, we have discussed. Let's instead of this break, right, let's remove this break. And here I write else. And then I write, okay, I will just copy paste it. Right, so for this a single number, instead if I have written not a prime, and in the else I have written it's a prime. Right, now let's execute it and I give it the number as it is giving number is prime. But is 45 prime? For that, let's check it from here. Just see, it is giving number is prime, not a prime, number is prime, not a prime. Is that possible? So there is some problem in the logic. And for that, we always say, don't believe in whatever is provided, whatever is given to you, whatever the information you are with, please try to explore that, right? And for our exploration, what we have done, we have removed break and we have gone for else. So it is giving us this. So how much time this for loop is working? This for loop is working 43 times. It is not working for 1, it is not working for 45. So please try to go for this type of wayouts, right? And I will simply go for that concept that was this only. And for that, if I go for its execution, what I am getting, it's not a prime, right? Let's execute it again. And for that, let me write 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. This is a prime number, right? As well as this is giving me the one line of answer. It is not giving me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 number of lines as the answer, right? So can I assume that you know how to create a program to check whether a number is prime or not? In case of any doubt, please provide the message, so that I can clear it in the next video.